Definitely didn't think I was gonna have to make this video right here, but they got me. After 1,000 trips, 5-star ratings, as well as only 4 actual bad reviews, which is anything less than a 5, which the lowest I've ever got was a 3-star. After all the batches of Instacart, I finally got one person who said that they did not receive their order. I look at the Google Maps, I confirm the address, and it's the same address. When I went in there and knocked on the door, the person who came to the door didn't seem like surprised that this was coming to the door. If I had an order show up to my house and someone knocked on the door and say, hey, I have your delivery, I would at least look shocked. Even if I was gonna keep it, I would look shocked, right? It's a food delivery. It's not like it's UPS, you know? So I know I didn't have the wrong address, because when I confirmed the address with the customer, she's like, yeah, that's my address, but I don't have it at my house. I was like, okay, well, on the Google Maps, this is your picture of that house. Is this not your house? No response. Then she wants to get on the phone with customer service, talking about, and then they call me saying, hey, what happened to the order? Nothing happened. You're talking to a person who's absolutely lying to you. But it is what it is. Hey, we all live and we learn. Now, from now on, as soon as I show up to your house, I'm just taking a quick picture of your house. And if and when this ever happens again, I'll be able to show you what house I took it to and the number that's on there, so that way you know that this is the correct address, and I'll report you. I'll call customer service before you even have a chance to. Unfortunately, the customer service that they call in on is people from Jamaica and things of that nature. When I call in, it's people from India, and they don't know, like they act like they don't know how to do the job for the most part, because there's like a language barrier. But Jamaicans, they speak English. It's just, you know, it's Jamaican English basically. So the person who called me to say, hey, I have the customer on the line, what happened? That's a Jamaican, which I didn't even know they even worked there, because every time I call in, it's always India, always. And I always get my issue taken care of. Sometimes it takes longer than it should, but it gets taken care of. On their side, they're getting to a person that is completely coherent, there's no language barrier, and it's all good. And they speak to them back and forth about it. Now they're questioning me about something where I know for facts this is your house. I know for facts that you're just lying. But at the same time, on the customer service side, because I've done customer service, they've probably dealt with drivers that lie. They probably dealt with low scoring drivers, period. And they've dealt with lying customers as well. So they don't really know who's telling the truth. All they're saying is, all right, cool, here's the issue. Let me talk to this party. Let me talk to that party. Cool. You guys are both basically saying the same thing. You're saying that your order didn't show up. He's saying that your order did show up. Okay, I don't know what's up. This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna refund your entire order over here, and then I'm gonna take money from the driver. And then I don't know, I didn't get an email or anything. Nothing happened on my end. There's no like internal message. So I don't know if that's on the background, a red check on my account now saying, all right, now you have one. And I don't know how many they'll let go by, which obviously if orders aren't showing up, it probably wouldn't be too many of them, right? Like out of 1,000 orders, 1,018 orders, I'm gonna start like taking it to the wrong spot. This is the beginning of the day. I can understand if I was driving all day and I just so happened to miss the turn and I took it somewhere else or whatever happened, or somewhere there was something that went wrong. But I'm talking about at the beginning of the day, third trip. Are you telling me that I'm not on point when I've been on point every single other time? That's wild. That is wild. But I understand, bro. Hey, we got every now and then we got to take it on the chin, and today was just my day to have to take it on the chin. So I wanted to make this video for anyone who's doing gig work. Take pictures of the order. Take pictures of the house. Do whatever you need to do, because they're more on the customer side than the driver side, because there's abundance of, there's a wait list of people trying to get onto Instacart. This is a good gig. So I definitely don't want to lose it over some person who lives in the ghetto, bro. And I can say that because I live in the ghetto too. But I know the type of neighborhood I took it to, and I know the type of people that live there, and sometimes they might do some shady stuff like this. And unfortunately, that's why I don't deliver to that part of town. I deliver to this part of town. So I go to Northwest Phoenix, Northeast Phoenix, Scottsdale's, far east like Chandler. I do those type of trips. I'm never in South Phoenix. I'm never in Midtown Phoenix. I'm never in these spots. And the store that I went to over here had an order that I accepted that was going that way. But it was a good order. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to go ahead and do it. Because, you know, like, I need money, right? Like, of course, that's what I'm out here doing is working. I don't want to sit at home all day, right? So that's what I'm doing. So wherever it's going is where I'm going to take it. Unless it's, like, too far for the money, you know? But it was a good trip. It was only 8 miles. And, you know, you live and you learn. Unfortunately, that's how it goes, bro. So understand the neighborhoods you're dropping off on, and understand that you need to take pictures of the house if you're doing Instacart especially. Because every now and then you'll have that person that says, oh, I didn't receive my order, and they're over there eating on whatever they ordered because they don't care about the driver. What they think about is what any thief would think about. Well, if I just dispute this, I'll get my money back and I'll have this. Bro, nothing's gonna happen to the driver. It doesn't matter, bro. Like, bro, it doesn't matter. Who cares? And unfortunately, it does affect the driver. No matter how good or how bad the driver is, you reporting that could possibly fire that person. And then that, unfortunately, that person has no income and has to go to a different thing like DoorDash or something else that doesn't pay as well. And you have to work a long, way, way long, long, long shift to even make what I'm making here. You know what I'm saying? And like, I'm not going to do anything. Even if I did get, you know, X'd out, I'm not going to do anything to the person. But in my mind, I'm thinking about like, oh, like it's like racing, right? So imagine someone else that's not as considerate or not as cool as I am, because that person would show back up at your house and talk about like, boom, put you on camera or try and do something to your property, things of that nature. I'm a grown adult. I know God got me. And your time is coming. When you're doing that type of stuff and you think it's all good, blah, 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 your time is coming, I promise you. I just let God take care of it. Ain't got nothing to do with me. I just wish I could see that live action. I wish I could see what happened to you live action. Because that way I could be like, you know what, that makes me feel better. You know, that something's being done about this. But that's not how God works. That's not what it's about. God works in different ways how God works. You know what I'm saying? It's not how I would do things. It's how God would do it. So it's not a big deal. You know what I'm saying? Like for me, I just feel frustrated because I'm out here making money for my family. I've been out here for hours. Today, I haven't been out there for that many hours. But I'm saying by the end of today, I will have been out here for hours to make my minimum so that way I can continue living the lifestyle that I'm living and continue saving the money and continue paying down the debt and continue investing on the things I invest in so that way I can continue to move forward in life. Like that's what anybody's doing. Some people use this as a complete side gig. Like, you know what? I work here and I do this on the side. I thought about doing that. I was like, you know what? What if I just did that? What if I had a guaranteed amount? Let's say I get paid $20 an hour guaranteed and I'm there for 8 hours. And then after that, I just go off and then do Instacart or DoorDash or whatever I can do to have extra money on top of it. And even with doing that plan, I still wouldn't make as much as I make with just doing this. I would have to get paid $30 an hour and have a 40-hour shift, 40-hour a week shift for that to even be possible. So for me, what is possible is doing it the way I'm doing it. And yes, me and my family do spend time together, whether it's before I go to work or whenever I get home late night. I don't get home late night. I get home at like 8:30, 9 p.m. and my wife's still up, so I hang out with her. And then my child and everybody else gets to see me, you know, on Sunday. And he'll see me before I go to work, but I gotta go to work, you know? And on Sundays, is my time with my family and my time with God, you know? That's what I got. So it is what it is, you know what I'm saying? These are the sacrifices I gotta make for going where I wanna go. I'm not trying to be broke for the rest of my life. I'm not trying to be in debt for the rest of my life. I got things to do. I'm a man on a mission. I've been that way for the past 4 or 5 months now, just continuing to do what needs to get done and not letting sidetracks be sidetracks, because that's all they are, is sidetrack. I don't want to be sidetracked. I need to get things done. And that's why I've been doing this YouTube thing, because YouTube is another way of making money, yes, but it's another way of connecting with an audience that is there and maybe might be going through something I'm going through, and I might be able to help them with their frustrations on how they should take care of their own by just saying something. Sometimes someone's on the edge and ready to just jump out the window on something, and they might come across a video like this and be like, I'm glad he said that right there, because that kept me from doing this right here. You know, like when you think about it, it's like, it's all water under the bridge. Don't worry about it. It's not a big deal, because no matter how bad the situation is, if you decide to jump out the window and it affects your real life forever, that situation didn't even last forever. So why even make a permanent decision over temporary circumstances, you know? And that's how I feel like, yeah, sure, this makes me mad. This makes me upset. This makes a feeling of retaliation for sure. But at the same time, if I act upon those feelings, then I'm gonna put myself in a worse position. And out here, it's not just me in these streets. It's me, my son, my wife. These are all people who depend on me to do well, to know where to go in life, to know that I have a structure, a plan, a direction, something. These people rely on me to do this. It's just like I think about drinking and driving. If I was out here drinking and driving, that decision can affect whether my son has a seat in a car to be able to ride around to the store or whatever. Or my wife, you know, same thing. So understand that, like, your decisions affect other people, even if it is just you. Your decisions can affect many different people. And sometimes it will just affect you, but you don't want to be like, you don't want that effect to be out here and have some permanent effects on your life, man. Like, I know I'm talking to somebody when I'm speaking, you know? I know somebody out there is thinking about it like, dang, that does make sense. Like, sometimes I let my temper go further than it should. Sometimes I overreact in situations where I shouldn't overreact, you know? Like, for me, what's hard on me is road rage. And I'm not saying I have a bunch of road rage, but I've definitely participated in my share of road rage. And the reason why road rage is so, it's so petty and dumb to even interact in that way, but the fact is that you even do it at all, it could literally change your life immediately. Just real quick. Like, you gotta understand, things can escalate so quickly and get ahead of you so fast that you don't understand, like, just let it go. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of what it feels like. This, just let it go. And there's people out there who are just losing it. And they're like, you know what? You want to do that to me? Today's the day that I'm going to go ahead and take it all the way to the max. And if you're not prepared for the max, you're going to be on the other end of being victimized, you know? So, got to learn how to control yourself, control your anger, control your mental state. It's just like me being, I'm biracial, so I'm mixed. I'm black and I'm white, you know? That's the simplest way to put it. I'm black and I'm white. I'm sure there's semantics of what form of white I am and semantics of what black I am. I don't know. But I'm just saying, just to make it easy, I'm half white, half black, right? And I've dealt with both sides of the party. One side I've dealt with where they have a certain way of thinking, and, you know, and certain people in my family are, you know, completely racist for sure. And then there's another end where, you know, my black side is a part I really don't even know because I don't know my dad. So my mom's side is all I have. So not just my family, I've just dealt with other people, right? When someone calls you the N-word and they drop the ER on it, right? What they're looking to do is inspire something within you to give them what they want, which is a reaction, whether it be full on negative or full on positive or whatever. They just want some kind of reaction from you. And a lot of people who do this are really uneducated because it's like their spade in spades, you know. It's like that card. It's like the magic card that they think they can pull and say, ha, you know, like, I couldn't get you with this, couldn't call you this, couldn't call you that, but I'm gonna call you this. And you're gonna get mad, and I knew I got to you, haha. You know, and if you let that get to you, it'll get to you for the rest of your life. That'll progress later on in life with other things. It's not just that, that's just a root problem. And these root problems build up over time. And you don't want these root problems to start really becoming real issues in your life, because these are things that can be easily fixed. You can literally fix these things within yourself. Because I used to overreact. I used to slam doors. I used to like do all types. I used to act out. You know what I'm saying? And that was obviously a time in life that I'm definitely not proud of. I never hurt nobody, but I definitely overreacted in many different situations for sure. But through those, I was able to get a level head on my shoulders to say, you know what, when I find myself trying to jump off the deep end, I think about how someone else is honestly going through something way worse than me, and I don't really have a right to be upset about this and take it out right now. Because what you're saying is you don't believe that person will get theirs. You know what I'm saying? It's not like I'm wishing it upon them, but they continue down that road. It doesn't lead to anything positive, and that person will get theirs. And they'll think about situations like this where this all compounded over time and made them, you see what I'm saying? Made them the person they are later on in life. So you honestly, with karma's real. Karma, what goes around comes around, all that stuff, it's completely real. If I steal something right now, I'll be charged with it later on. And I could get away with it from the store or whatever, and no, none of the store would never catch me. But later in life, something will catch me, and I'll be like, why did this happen? Well, you shouldn't have did this, you shouldn't have did that. I'm gonna tell you a quick story, and I'm gonna end this video. So quick story is, I used to do black and milds, right? And I'm over here on this military base. Whenever I used to do cab driving, I would drive military people all over the place. And a lot of times it'd be back on the base, which is Camp Pendleton in San Diego. It's a huge base, so big that it almost has two zip codes, you know? It's crazy big. So one of these times I've taken this guy to the PX, which is like their local convenience store basically. And I took him to the PX. And I was like, yo, do you think you can give me a pack of black and milds? And I was like, just don't get the wood tip, get plastic, right? And so he goes in and gets the wood tip. I was like, dang. So I was like, you know what? He didn't have time to switch them for me. So I just like went back in there. And I was like, hey, you just sold it to me. And I need this instead of this. And she said, okay, cool. So she swaps them out, hands me the plastic ones. And then, so I have them. So I'm about to head out, and she's like, let me see your military ID, because at the PX you have to be military. No civilians can actually shop there. And she is doing that because that's what they do. They always ask for this. I was like, oh my God. So I just was like, no, yeah, it's in my car. And I walked off, got in the car, started my car, just gone. Like, ah, I got it, you know? And not even like I got 0.25 mile away, like not even a quarter mile away, is a cop just sitting there. The military police just sitting there. Boom, pull up on me. Pull me over, and I'm thinking it's that because like that's still technically stealing, because you know, I'm not sure how it is, but it's still technically stealing. So I get pulled over and they gave me a ticket. So the pack costs $5.67 or something like that, like $5-6. That ticket cost me $220. So had I not went in there with a lie and walk in there and swap it out real quick and bounced and did all that extra stuff, I wouldn't have been held accountable with the ticket. And at that time, it's a speeding ticket. So I didn't even have a ticket in so long. Speeding ticket on a federal base, bro. Dude. I know some people hear that story and be like, well, what's this have to do with this? I promise you. Everything has to do with everything. And had I not went in there and told this person a lie, then lied again, went back to my car trying to get away on the getaway, I wouldn't have been pulled over by that cop because I wouldn't have been speeding. Everything has to do with everything. So I got held accountable. That was the most expensive black and milds I've ever bought in my entire life. So that's why I live my life this certain way, because I've been held accountable instantly. Now, before, I could get away with everything. The later on in life I've become, everything is just came around, especially this year. This year is a karmic year. This year is the year of the eight, and it's karma. What goes around, comes around. Goes around, comes around. An infinite loop. I am personally an eight as well. So just understand that this year, everybody's getting theirs, whether good or bad. And this year is my year in Chinese, I was about to say zoology. In Chinese zodiac, this is my year. So I can't mess it up. You know what I'm saying? Otherwise, it'll take another cycle, and unfortunately that's another decade away, and I don't think that. I just know that right now is my time. Okay, right now is my chance, my opportunity, and I've got to get this right. So I'm gonna do everything I need to do, and I take the hits as I take the hits and pivot, and that's what I'm doing right now. I thank you guys so much for tuning in. I had to go in and shop this order. I appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. Leave a comment down below, or any questions you got, leave a question and I will go ahead and answer it with a video. I appreciate every single one of you. If you're not subscribed already, please subscribe. Join the journey, bro. We are growing so fast. I appreciate all of you guys. See you on the next one. Peace!